We're just about ready to kick off today's qualifying here in Melbourne. It's the Australian Grand Prix. And as we wait, poised for the start of what will hopefully be a thrilling qualifying, why don't you tell us, Anthony Davidson, about the things you can do to really get the most out of a car in a session like this?
Well, you're largely limited by the Parc Fermé regulations, of course. Back in the old days, pre-2004, you'd work on both a qualifying setup and a race setup over practice, and then swap them over after qualifying. So the race car was quite different at times to the qualifying car. Nowadays, though, you have to find a compromise that works for both. There are a few things that you can still adjust during the session, such as the differential, the brake bias, and the front wing angle, but that's about it. So it's more about optimizing what you do have and adapting your own style to suit the track conditions.
Thank you.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. The Professor, Hamilton, and Charles Leclerc. With qualifying wrapped up, we now have our grid lineup for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a fantastic race. New drivers, new cars, it's a new Formula One season. But it's the same Albert Park that we've come to know and love for more than two decades now that plays host to round one of a 21-race championship that takes us from here in Australia, across the globe, and the eventual season finale at the Yas Island Circuit in Abu Dhabi. So here we are at Albert Park Circuit. 3.3 miles of public roads, closed for the weekend, of course, make for a bumpy surface with little undulation. There are 16 corners around the lake with the best passing opportunities coming at turn one and turn three. We have plenty of changes to the sport this year with tweaks to the regulations, a fresh looking spread of tyre compounds, and of course some changes to the roster of car manufacturers. It's goodbye to Sauber and hello once again to the classic name of Alfa Romeo in Formula One. It's also goodbye to Force India. They've been rebranded as Racing Point. Joining me to take you through all the action of the 2019 Formula One season is Anthony Davidson. And it's great to have you with us.
Thanks, Crofty. Always happy to be here, and I'm looking forward to getting underway. Last year was Mercedes' fifth constructors' title in a row, although for the first half of the season, it was absolutely neck and neck with the Ferraris. Hopefully this year we can see the chasing pack take that final step, as I'd love to see a championship contest all the way up to the final race in Abu Dhabi. Another story to keep an eye on is the performance of Red Bull, who have switched to the Honda power unit this year. What that will mean for both their performance and reliability remains to be seen.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. The Professor lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Weber, Max Verstappen, and Norris, Raikkonen, Ricciardo, Perez, and Daniel Kvyat, Sainz, Butler, Kevin Magnussen, and Hülkenberg, Grosjean, Giovinazzi, Pierre Gasly, and Lance Stroll. Russell and Robert Kubica takes the last spot on the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Thank you.
So, another excellent win from Ferrari. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, tyre management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. So let's review the updated driver's standings. The Professor takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Lance Stroll certainly put in an impressive performance today. No doubt his team and fans are extremely proud.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari take the lead at the top of the table. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. You took the top points today. Was it a comfortable win? You're breaking all expectations. What's your secret? You've had experience with Devon's fast, aggressive style. Any advice for the drivers he passed today? Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash? Great. Well, that's everything.